Hey guys, welcome back. This week we're going to spend some time working on a new project, one that I've never really attempted, haven't had much interest or opportunity really to attempt it, but I'm going to be making a reflexed and recurved bow. It's kind of got five curves to it, so there's going to be recurves, and I'm going to attempt to make them as static recurves, and that limb is going to be recurved and come to a deflexed grip. So there's going to be like five curves to this particular bow. This is going to be a new thing for me, so I'm always up for a challenge, and this is certainly presenting to be one. I'll tell you what, I'll stop talking about it. We'll just dive right in. I'm gonna try and keep this all straight as I attempt to explain how I am going to construct this bow. I have been mulling over all of the aspects, not only in composition, design, how exactly I'm going to glue it, if I'm going to use a mold, or how I was going to make this happen. And since this is going to require some tillering that I'm not accustomed to, I wanted to make sure that the shape of the limbs kind of took on their own bend, right? So we're gonna do kind of like we did with the bamboo back and belly, the reflex deflex. But in any event, bamboo back and belly. Here is a piece of hickory, and you can kind of see it was like the outside edge of a piece that I picked up for backing strips. So it's got really good grain to it, but somebody beat on it with a hammer. Could just kind of heartbreaking to take that first strip off, but as a center strip or as a interior lamination, these little divots aren't going to have any negative effect on the finish. So what I'm going to do is make this 10 inches shorter than the bow itself. So I've got a 64 inch bamboo back, which is going to be thinned and tillered. Arc of the circle. I just want even bend through that bamboo. And then taper this to a length of 54 inches. So I finish 5 inches short of the tips of the bow. With the remainder of this, so if I cut it off here, I can get 2 9-inch strips that I'm going to then taper like a reverse taper at the tips to help reinforce the recurve. All right, so 54 inches tapered out to, I'm going to try and feather the tip as a matter of fact. And then the back wedge, I'm almost going to feather it back this direction so that it glues on. And we go from grip thick, thinning out right to the bend of the recurve. And then we start getting thick again so that we can make this more of a static recurve than a working recurve. And maximize that aspect of the design. Had some trouble with trying to decide how to do the grip, and so being the industrious type person and or lazy, I don't know which to describe it as, I got some of these power lambs that have been kicking around that are really pretty thick, but if you look at it from a different direction, they could make almost the perfect grip piece, and I don't know if you can really see it, that there we go, it make almost a perfect grip riser, so the back of the bow would be right here, so we'd have the the hickory strip go on, and then the bamboo backing, and this will give us the deflex, or not deflex but reflex at the grip going into our deflexed limb and into the recurve. So I'm thinking this might actually work, and the beautiful part about that is I already have a, should I want to do any future builds, I've got the pattern for it right here. So we're gonna try that. Okay, and then for the recurves, I'm going to use, or I'm going to steam and bend the recurves in. As I mentioned, I want to make them static as much so as possible. And so got some 3/4 inch MDF here. Going to cut this out and make make the molds. Okay, and I'll put a card in right here about how I make my molds out of MDF so that they're, you know, perfect as far as being smooth and ready to go and all four or both parts. So I'm going to do two of them. So there's one for the bottom tip and then I'll do one for the top tip. Not only will I use these to steam in the bend initially, I think I'm also going to use them in the course of gluing this bow. And so when we get it put together and everything's wrapped and we put the tip in here and we bend it out here and the rest of everything's all wrapped, and as we get the limbs to do their little deflex at mid-limb, this should actually pivot on this, so it'll rock a little bit. We can keep the grip reflexed and let the limbs determine the shape of the deflex. And that way, tillering shouldn't be as complicated as I feel like this bow will be. I'm just not accustomed to doing it. When I look at that design, I just think that deflex right outside of the fades just screams hinge at me, which again is why I'm using bamboo to construct this. I think the bamboo can stand up to the task, and we will find out. So all right, so I've steamed this core piece, the hickory, and you can see that it is tapered down to very almost to a feathered edge on these edges, and then of course thicker through the gap or through the grip. In the process of steaming it, it's cupped a little bit like this right here. So I tried to put some clamps on it to straighten it out. Hopefully that doesn't create a problem during the glue up or anything. So we got that going on. Once I take this out of the, actually I'm going to take it out of the clamp, and then we'll have then the next piece of or the backing piece of bamboo to do the same. So there's kind of the angle of that guy, and this of course is so that it will fit into this nice and easy, and it should, because now we're going to have to spread it out to get it to fit, which I think will work better than trying to squeeze it into the center. All right, guys, here we go. Going to steam bend these sia pieces more or less right quick. And if you're wondering what the story is with the plastic on my mold, it's got everything to do with the fact that I was boiling these pieces as opposed to steaming them, and the moisture on MDF is like a recipe for disaster. It'll just bubble up and whatnot. And so what this does, it's just protecting the MDF from the moisture, because I put that directly in boiling water, these pieces. All right, so there we go. I'm gonna do the second one here, and then we'll allow them to cool and move on from there. Here's where we're at. All the pieces are pretty much put together. The only thing left to do with the reinforcement pieces for the recurves is to get a tapered edge here so that we can basically attach it to our center core and use that at the tips of the bow. So we have both of those put together. We have our riser here, which actually would go like this, I guess, if we're putting it together in order. Our back, our core. In the end, here's how all those pieces are going to go together. In tight at the grip, will be recurved out at our ends, and have a deflex in the center here somehow. Still working on how that's going to actually happen, but basically here are the parts, and gluing this together is really going to be a challenge, and I am trying to sort out whether or not this is going to be a one and done gluing operation, or if I'm going to glue it together in stages, you know, so like glue together the back and the core to the riser and then add the belly, or even just glue the core to the riser with the recurves and then glue on the back and the belly. I'm gonna have to sleep on this. Just not entirely sure how I'm going to make that all happen without everything coming apart on me. So at any rate, here we are. Here's all our parts. That was a process for getting all of our parts in order. And like I said, the only thing left to do is just take the leading edge on these sias, or reinforcement pieces, if you will. They're really not sias in any way, shape, or form. It's just a recurve reinforcement piece, but just tapering out that leading edge so that it will glue seamlessly into the construction there. That is all that's left to be done, and then we will glue together. So join me next week, guys. It's sure to be an interesting episode to see how this all goes together. So thanks for hanging in with me this long, and I will see you next week.